Hi there, welcome once again, and this is the time for learning text animation in Adobe Premiere Pro. This is one of the essential things in video editing, and many times you have to animate your text or image in video editing. So question is, what is text animation? Let me explain you about the text animation with an example, and you can take a look. We added a video file from our exercise file in our project timeline. So let me play this video clip, and please keep your eye on left bottom.
Hi there.
Okay, you can take a look. This Stephen Quayle Shoren, this text is appeared at left bottom, and let me place this indication bar at beginning, and let me play this once again.
Hi there.
Okay, this text is appeared in here from bottom, and when the indication bar or the video is going to be started, the text is disappeared. So let me play this one.
Hi there.
But after crossing 1 second, this text is appeared, and this is called a text animation. So let me show you another example, and please keep your eye on right bottom.
I am Stephen Quayle Shoren, and I am a graphics and a web expert. This is a
okay, cool. You can take a look. This subscribe image is animating over here, and the name of this animation called rotation. So let me play this once again.
Class about Adobe Photoshop, and the levels is beginner. So it
okay, cool. So this image is animating over here, and let me show you another example.
If you absolute beginner, or if you never open Photoshop before, then you don't have to worry about this. This is the perfect class for you for learning Adobe Photoshop.
Okay, you can take a look. This text is moving from left to right, and this is called the text animation. So let's take a look how you will apply the text or image animation on your video footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. So you can take a look. I placed a video clip from our exercise file, and the name of the video clip is intro clip 1. This clip I used many times before in our previous lesson. So as we are going to learn about the text animation, that's why we have to type a text, and you know which tool you have to use for typing the text. Yes, you are right, we have to use the type tool. So this is the type tool, and we have to use it for typing a name. Okay, so I want to type a name over here at left bottom, and as an example, let me write my name. So let me write my name, Stephen Quayle Shoren. Okay, so this is my name, and you can take a look. We have some settings appear in our effect control, so we are going to make some animation with these settings. So let's start the making animation for the text with these settings. So we are going to make an animation for the text disappeared to appeared. So I'm going to disappear this text from this video clip right now, but when the video clip will be started, then this text will be appear at left bottom, and that's why we have to use the settings of motion, and under the motion we have position and scale. So we're going to make the animation with the position and keyframe. Right now we have the 960 point and 540 point for the position, and this is the settings for height and width. So right now I'm going to disappear this text from this video clip. That's why I have to use this height point. This is the height point, and this is the width point, and these points are using for position. So I want to disappear, I want to pull, or I want to bring this text at bottom outside of the video. Then we have to move or change this height point. This is the height point of position, and this is the width point of position. If you want to place or move this text at bottom, then you have to increase the position or point of height. So right now we have 540 point, but I want to place or move this text at bottom. So that's why I'm going to type 640. So as I want to place this text more below. Okay, I just placed 640 point, and you can take a look, the text is placed more bottom than before. And if you want to move or place this text at top, in that case you have to reduce the height point. You can use your mouse or you can put the manual value. So let me use the mouse. I want to reduce the point, and you can take a look, with the reducing of point our text is moving at top. Okay, right now we have minus 244 point, and the text is placed at top. So I'm going to disappear this text at bottom. So that's why I have to increase the height point, and I'm going to make this video clip away from the main screen. Okay, right now we have the text out of our main video frame, and it's placed below the main frame. And right now we have to add a keyframe. So this is the option for keyframe, and when you will click, then a keyframe will be added to our graphics part. So this is the graphics part, this is the graphics part as well. So let me click on this keyframe position. Okay, and you can take a look, a keyframe is placed in our graphics part. So right now this text is placed with this keyframe at outside of the video frame. But when you will play this video clip, and if you want to appear this text at left bottom, then you have to make another keyframe, and you have to select the same position. But right now if you play this video clip, nothing will be happen. Let me show you.
Hi there, I am Stephen Coyle Short.
Okay, you just seen the video is played, but the text is not animated. As because we placed with the keyframe with the text at outside of the screen. So we are going to make it visible, and we have the 0 second for the beginning, but I want to appear this text within 2 seconds. So this is the 2 second, and I want to make visible the text within 2 seconds. So right now we have placed the indication bar at 2 seconds, and now we have to make the text appear in our video frame. Right now the text is placed outside of video frame. So as we are going to place the text at left bottom, so we have to make it visible, and we have to place the text at our video frame. And you know, to make or move the text at top, you have to reduce the height point. So let me reduce the height point, and I want to place the text over here. Okay, so you can take a look, and another keyframe is added on here, and it will be added manually when you are going to work with the keyframe. So right now we have two keyframe, this is one and this is another. So let me move this indication bar at beginning for the first keyframe. Okay, right now our video indication bar is placed on 0 second at the beginning, and we have a keyframe for the 0 second. And with this keyframe, the text is placed outside of screen. But when you will play the video clip, when it will come over 2 seconds, then the text will be appeared at left bottom. So let me play this one.
Hi there, I am Stephen Coyle Short, and I am a graphic.
Okay, cool, you can take a look, it's appearing from outside of screen. to left bottom of the screen. So let me play once again.
Hi there, I am Stephen Coyle Short.
Okay, cool. As we placed the keyframe only for the height point, that's why it's animating with the height position. But if you want to make the text animation for width part, you can do that easily. So let's make another animation for width point, and I'm going to type a new text, and I want to place the new text after 8 seconds. So right now the indication bar plays at 8 seconds, and I'm going to type a new text. So here is the type tool. So let me type some new text. So as this video clip is about intro of professional Photoshop course, so I want to write professional Photoshop course. Okay, professional Photoshop course, and I want to move this text from left to right, and that's why we have to use the keyframe with the position of width point. So this was the height and this is the width. So right now we have 960 point for the width, and we have to add a keyframe with this point. And you know, you have to click over here for adding a keyframe, and you can take a look, a keyframe is added at 960 point. And I want to place the indication bar for 11 seconds. So when this video will be crossed at 11 seconds, this text should be at right. And that's why we have to move or change the point of width. So as I'm going to move this text from left to right, so we have a keyframe at our left position, and when the indication bar will cross for 11 seconds, then this text should be at right. And I'm going to increase the point of width. Right now we have 960 point, so for moving the text at right, you have to increase the point. So you can put the manual value over here, or you can use the mouse for moving or increasing the width point. So I'm using the mouse for moving the text at right. Okay, cool. And you can take a look, and another keyframe is added over here. So this keyframe, the first keyframe for the left position of text, and the second keyframe is applied for the moving text at right. So let's play the video clip.
Adobe Photoshop and the labels is beginner. So if
okay, you just seen this text is moved from left to right, and this is the magic of keyframe along with the position. So this is how you will make an animation of text in Adobe Premiere Pro using position. So right now we are going to learn about the animation of rotation and animation of zoom, and that's why I want to import two image from our exercise file. So let's import it. Here is the file menu, and here is the import option. Okay, in our exercise file, you will get this Laura Vargas. This is a JPEG image, and it's downloaded from unsplash.com. And another one is the subscribe image. So you just have to select them all, and then you just have to click open. Okay, cool. So this is our image. So at first I'm going to work with the rotation, and that's why I want to place this subscribe image at our project timeline, and that's why you have to drag and drop this image, and I want to place it over here. Okay, so let's place the indication bar to our subscribe image. Okay, so this is the subscribe image, and I want to place it at right bottom, and I want to make a rotation animation for this subscribe image. So you just have to select this subscribe image graphics at our project timeline, and then you have to place this subscribe image at right bottom. So how you will place it, you have to move the position. So let me move this subscribe image at bottom by increasing the point of height, and then I want to place this subscribe button at right, and that's why we have to use the width position point. And I'm going to increase the point of width position, and then you will be able to move the image at right. Okay, cool. So right now we have the perfect placement, but if you think this image seems bigger and if you want to make it smaller, then you have to go for a scale option. Right now we have 100% scale, and if you want to reduce the size of this image, in that case you can reduce the point of scale. So right now we have 100 point, and I'm going to put 90 point for scale as I want to make it smaller. Okay, now it seems smaller than before, and if you want to make it bigger, then you have to go for more than 100 points. So let me write 150 point, and you can take a look, this image seems quite bigger, but it's not really looks good. So I'm going to put 90 point. Okay, now it really looks well. So as I'm going to make a rotation animation, that's why we have to use this rotation option. And right now we have 0 point, as this image is placed at 0 point and it's the standard value of rotation. So I want to move at left and right rotation. So that's why at first I have to add a keyframe for minus point. So if you make this rotation point negative or minus, then this image will be rotated like that. So I want to go for minus 20 point. Okay, I placed for minus 20 point. So when you will place the minus point, the image will be rotated at left side. And right now we have minus 20 point, and I'm going to add a keyframe. And to add a keyframe, you have to click on this toggle animation option at rotation, and you can take a look, a keyframe is added. So minus 20 degree rotation is placed when the video clip will be played at 17 seconds, but I want to move this image at right side when this video clip will arrive at 18 seconds. So when this video will be arrived at 18 seconds, then this image will be rotated at right side, and that's why I want to place the plus 20 point for this rotation. Right now we have the minus 20 degree, and for 18 seconds we want to place it plus 20 degrees. So you can put the manual value as well, or if you want to use your mouse, then you can move the mouse as well. And you just have to increase the point, and you can take a look, when we are increasing the point, the image of subscribe is rotating at right. Okay, right now we have 20 degree, and you can take a look, and another keyframe is added. So let me play this one from the beginning.
You don't have to worry about this.
Okay, you just seen this image is animated from minus 20 degree to plus 20 degree. So I want to move this image for minus 20 degree or in left direction at 19 seconds. So right now we have the 18 second, but I want to move the image at left direction at 19 seconds. So that's why we have to move the indication bar at 19 seconds. Okay, right now we have our indication bar at 19 seconds, and in this point or in this time frame, I am going to add and another keyframe for minus 20 degree. So let's make it minus 20. And you can take a look, the image is rotating at left direction. Okay, so when I just used minus 20 degree, this image is rotated at negative or left direction. So we have another keyframe at 19 second, and for 20 second I want to place another keyframe, and that will be plus 20 degree and at right direction. So let's place the indication bar for 20 second. Okay, this is the 20 second, and in this 20 second I want to add another keyframe for plus 20 degree. Okay, let me write the manual value. Okay, cool. And you can take a look, and another keyframe is added. But when the duration of this graphics will be finished, I want to bring it at the general or 0 degree rotation. So let me move the indication bar for 21 second or 22 seconds. I think 21 second is good. 21 second, and when the video will be crossed at 21 second, this image should be at like previous position at 0 degree position of rotation. That's why in this point or in this time frame I want to place 0 degree rotation. Okay, right now we have the 0 degree rotation, and another keyframe is added, and we have the plane or actual rotation at 21 second. So let's time for playing this video clip. Let me place the indication bar at here, and let me play the video clip.
Then you don't have to worry about this. This is the perfect class for you for learning Adobe Photoshop.
You just seen we have a rotated animation of subscribe image, and it's really very effective for your YouTube channel. If you have any YouTube channel, then you can use this animation for attracting your audience. So this is the simple way for making rotation of an image with the rotation keyframe animation toggle in Adobe Premiere Pro. So time for final one, and we are going to learn right now about the zoom in and zoom out animation effect for an image or text in Premiere Pro. And that's why I'm going to place this Laura Vargas JPEG image in our project timeline. And that's why you just have to apply the drag and drop method. And I have to place it over here. So let's place the indication bar to our image, and you can take a look. Here is the preview of our image, and here it seems the size of image is quite bigger than our actual frame size, and we have to scale it. And that's why you just have to select this image, and you can zoom in or you can enlarge the area of your timeline. So you can just pull or push this bar at left and right, or you can use the keyboard plus or minus button for zoom in or zoom out. So let me press the plus button from my keyboard, and I have a zoom in effect applied. And to scale this image with our frame size, you just have to right click with your mouse in this image, and then you will get this scale to frame size option. So let me click on this scale to frame size, and you can take a look. The image is scaled with our frame size. Okay, so I am going to make a zoom in animation for this image, and that's why I want to place this indication bar at the beginning of this image. Okay, cool. And we have to use this scale keyframe option for making zoom in animation. And right now we have 100% or 100 point scale size. And in this scale size, I am going to add a keyframe. So here is the option. You just have to click on this toggle animation option, and you can take a look. A keyframe is added over here. But when this video will be crossed for 28 seconds, as we have 25 seconds time frame, and I'm going to make a zoom in effect at 28 seconds. That's why. Let's move this indication bar at 28 seconds. Okay, here is the 28 second. So when this video will be crossed at 28 second, this image should be at zoomed in, and that's why you have to increase the scale. So right now we have 100 point for scale, and if you want to make it zoom, you have to increase it. So you can put the manual value or you can use your mouse. So let me use 150 point, and you can take a look. This image is zoomed in and a new keyframe is added. So let's play this one.
Photoshop, this is a project based class, so you can
so you just seen the zoom in effect is applied with the keyframe, and this is the feature of scale. And if you want to zoom out, in that case you just have to place the minus point for here. Okay, so this is the quite simple process for applying the zoom in or zoom out animation using the keyframe in Premiere Pro. I think this tutorial gets some longer tutorial, and if you are absolute beginner, it may become little tough for understand. So I'm requesting you, please watch it for 2 or 3 times for getting the clear concept about making the animation of text and image. So let's have some practice.